So good morning students, chapter number 3, money and credit. Okay, so of course now money and credit, I think you are well versed with both the words. Now what is money we are going to see in terms in a theoretical way. You know what is money, you have been handling money, but what exactly it means from the economic part of view, that we are going to focus on today's subject, like today's period. Okay. So what is money, currency and bank deposits? We have already studied this in 8th standard if you remember. Okay. And even in 6th standard if you were the Walnutians. Okay. So are you ready for economics early morning? I hope you are. Okay. So we are all familiar with money. But has it always been around in the form we know? The way we are seeing money right now, okay, like you also have written answers on like now even the plastic money, the card money is coming up. So was it the same initially? Barter system was practiced to acquire and exchange goods. We all know this, isn't it? But it wasn't quite as effective. Can you guess the reasons why? Yeah, I would like to have the reasons in the chat box. They do not have any set of measures to identify the price of a product. Yes. One more thing you can add. Yes, the trade may not be equal. Now suppose if we take, we have an example. Last year we have studied an example like the shoemaker and the farmer who is selling rice. Okay, so in a particular area, rice is grown. So the farmers will exchange rice only for the commodity or the service they want, right? So now the shoe rice, because that is grown in abundant, right? So the thing is, after some time, the community helper or the potter or the shoemaker can think that, okay, this is enough. I don't want to trade now. I don't want any more rice. So in that case, the trade is unequal. Okay. So sometimes they won't need the trade. They don't want to exchange. But it was then a bit compulsory part and it was a biased thing. Okay. So whatever reasons you have given are correct. Barter system required that both, that is the customer and seller, must accept the goods being exchanged. So they should be happy doing that. This is known as the double coincidence of wants. But we know that may not always be the case. Could you say why? So we have already discussed this, isn't it? I mean, let's have two unique answers at least. So money therefore works to eliminate this very problem. It functions like a medium instead and thus known as the medium of exchange. So money is also known as the medium of exchange. And it eliminates, like if you have the money, everyone wants the money and ready for an exchange, ready to trade. Now let's talk about the form of money. Do you think the notes and coins we use have been the only form? Of course not. We have been seeing from 3rd standard, right? So, of course not. In the olden days, grains, cattle, or coins of various metals were used. Eventually, we came to have the paper notes and coins, what we are using today. Now, this currency has been authorized by the central government and is minted and distributed by the Reserve Bank of India. Now, this sentence is very important from the point of one mark answer. Okay. So, the currency has been authorized by the central government and is minted and distributed by the Reserve Bank of India, that is RBI. The rupee is our official and only legal currency authorized to be used within the country. Now, why is money accepted in any transaction? Such type of the questions having such meaning can be asked. So the reason is that the rupee or the currency what we are using is authorized by the central government, and hence it is accepted as a medium of exchange. Getting it? I would like to repeat here that the question may come somewhat with the same meaning as why the rupee is accepted for trade or exchange of goods. Okay, so the answer is the rupee is an official currency authorized by the central government. That is why it is accepted for trade and exchange. Okay, so not given very right. You have to use your logic brains for giving the answer. Straightforward sentence you won't get anywhere in the chapter. Okay, we don't carry all the currency we have with us all the while. Okay, we deposit it in a bank account, right? We agree to this, right? All of us follow the same thing. The money remains safe, and we also earn interest on the depositor money. Though it has been put up in the saving account, then also we get a small interest on that money. This deposited money can be withdrawn as per requirement. As and when you require, you can withdraw the money. Now, priorly, few years back, it was you have to go to the bank and then withdraw the money, but now with the ATM cards and the internet banking, the QR code scanning and everything, like payments are become, or the withdrawal of the money is becoming very, very easy. So this deposited money can be withdrawn as per requirement, so they are also known as demand deposits. So here, whatever things are highlighted, whatever words are highlighted, those are important, and the concept of it is important. This may be asked as one mark questions. Okay. What is demand deposit? What is interest? Okay. Such type of questions. These are simple questions, but yes, the sentences are important. Mark them out. And this may be asked for your one mark question. Bank accounts facilitates the use of checks too. So if it is a big amount and if you want to pay after some time, so you can use the checks also to give up or to do the with the bigger amounts. Okay. Where now, even if you're using a internet banking or debit cards or credit cards, they have a limit, right? You can withdraw only a limited amount in a day. So if you have to pay much more than whatever is your limit of the account, then you have to give the checks. For bigger amounts, you need to give the checks. Okay, so we were talking about checks. Yes, counterfeit checks normally, and now with the security they have built up, the Reserve Bank have worked on, so there is now hardly things that check might get counterfeit. Nowadays there are cyber crimes going on instead of all these small things. People don't work on this rather, but yes, like there is some code being put up. Okay, then there are different security measures taken. Like nowadays you have the printed, priorly the check, well, you don't come to know like whose checkbook it was. Anyone could have sent, and now it embeds your name also, right? Your account number is also embedded. Priorly, you had to write your account number. It was a common checkbook given to distributed to anyone who asked for it. But now there is a security that you have the name, you have the signature, you have the name of your own on the checkbook. Okay. Apart from that, the coding is also done, which cannot be copied, so now things are safe. Okay, now this eliminates the need for cash transactions. So with the check, you don't have to withdraw a lump sum amount and give it to some other person. Instead of that, a small piece of check can help you out. Now let us study the features of check. Here it is again. The pay, whom you have to pay, how much amount you have to pay. Your account number is there. Okay. Then here, valid for whatever the amount is. I think so. Yeah, 10 lakh and under that. Okay. So it has a limit. Above that, you also can't give the check. Okay. Now here, sign above. But nowadays, this is also quite old check, we can say. Here also now the your name is embedded by that particular bank. Okay, so let us see more features of it. Who you are paying to, how much, so in words as well as words, so that suppose if you by mistake you write a wrong number, still you come to know it is just a cross checking. That is why yes only is also compulsory. We end with that, otherwise somebody can add up more amount. Okay, there can be manipulation in this. That is why writing only at the end of the amount is mandatory. Okay, next, the account number of the person who is paying means I have to pay, suppose Mihir Bajaj, then the account number will be from my bank account's number. Okay, my saving account number, my current account number will be there, the person who is paying. Okay, then this is a check number. Okay, which is in the apostrophes, we can see. Now this is MICR code. Now what is MICR code? Any idea? It is magnetic ink character recognition code. Okay, it has some typical type of ink which can be read by some electronic device only, and it always has 9 characters, 9 digits. Okay, and this shows that which branch of that particular bank is the check of. Okay, so this is the code. What I said, that there are some codes where you made sure that this number cannot be anything that should have the code of that particular bank. The branch code is there. Bearer means if you are not crossed, suppose if it is with your name and so Shubham Baraskar's name, and then even Shubham Deshpande can withdraw it. Now MICR checks the originality of that particular document, and remember it is always 9 digit. This can come as a KBC question. Okay, now account number of the bank as registered with the RBI. Okay, if it is not crossed na Shubham Baraskar, then you like anybody can withdraw the money or put the check and cash the check. So for your safety, you have to always cross it. So only that person. Nowadays, even if you have to pass the check, you have to show your identity. If you give me a check, then I have to prove with my Aadhaar card or voter ID that I am Pallavi Guzar. It's not that, okay, you write my name, you cross the check and I go to the bank and I just take out the money. Now it is not that very simple. Either you deposit the money or you withdraw the money. You have to show the identity card, I card. Okay, now normally they ask for Aadhaar card nowadays. Now what is that? The last 2 digits is a transaction code. Okay, so in this way, when a check you deposit in the bank, then the concerned person checks all these things and then only they shift the amount to your account. Okay, so in this way there are very less chances of counterfeit. Now, why are demand deposits considered as money? Money that is deposited and withdrawn as per demand essentially is money.
If you like our videos, do share them and subscribe to our channel. If you want awesome quizzes, write to us. Keep watching and keep learning with Walnut.